Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain.
Hello, a very good day to you. My name is Sister Temitayo, and I'm here once again to share the Open Heavens Daily Devotional compiled by the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. So if you're visiting my channel for the very first time, or if you know me personally, you may be asking why I'm sharing from this particular Christian book. The reason is because the Lord instructed me to do so as I prepared to enter into the year 2020, which was 4 years ago, and that's why we call it Season 4. And all those videos from 2020, the Open Heavens videos from 2020 are all loaded on my YouTube channel. My handle on YouTube is Temi Agedo. I encourage you to visit to view the old Open Heavens videos and also to view the daily Open Heavens video for that particular day. And while you're on there, please do subscribe and God bless you. Pastor Deborah led me to Christ in October 1997, a few years back when I was an undergraduate in the University of Lagos, Nigeria in West Africa. And Pastor gives you a few scriptures from the Bible. He gives you a memory verse. And when you combine those two pieces of scripture, it helps you to understand the body of the text and what the Spirit of God is saying to the reader of the daily devotional. Praise God. So today is Monday, May the 22nd. And the title of today's daily devotional is Check Your Friends. Check Your Friends. Praise God. And the scriptural reading is taken from Proverbs chapter 1, verses 10 to 19. Proverbs chapter 1, verses 10. To 19. Now, I normally read from King James, but I find it easier to understand from the New Living Translation. Proverbs chapter 1, verses 10 to 19. New Living Translation. This goes the reading of God's word. Solomon says, "My child, if sinners entice you, turn your back on them. They may say, 'Come and join us. Let us hide and kill someone just for fun. Let's ambush the innocent. Let's swallow them alive like the grave. Let's swallow them whole like those who go down to the pit of death. Think of the great things we'll get. We'll fill our houses with all the stuff we take. Come, throw in your lot with us, and we'll all share the loot. My child, don't go along with them. Stay far away from their paths. They rush to commit evil deeds. They hurry to commit murder. If a bird sees a trap being set, it knows to stay away. But these people set an ambush for themselves. They are trying to get themselves killed. Such is the fate of all who are greedy for money. It robs them of life." May God bless the reading of his word. Now, if you look at the first verse that we read, "My child, if sinners entice you." So Solomon is like talking to the covenant child and saying that if sinners entice you, that is, you are brought up in a good home, you are a Christian child. Let me just put it that way. And somebody who is from, not from your background comes and says, "You know what, look, I have a business deal for you. This is good. Look, there's a kind of business I do, you know, it's, you know, don't, quick money, sugar sharp, everything. They're enticing you. Yes, we'd be required to carry a gun. We are not going to use it." You know, he said, don't listen to them. Don't let them entice you. And don't continue to listen to them, because the more you listen to them, faith will be, you know, stirred up in you to follow them that, oh no, you know, we'll just do this. He said, don't turn your back on them. You see, because these people have come, they want to steal and to kill and to destroy. So that these are sons of Belial, sons and daughters of Belial. Don't listen to them. Don't let them entice you. So, you know, he's saying to the child, don't go along with them. Stay far away from their paths. So for young, not only for young people, you know, even somebody may say, I know some quick way to do business. Yes, things are tight for you now, but look unto Jesus Christ, the author and the finisher of your faith. The Bible says, better is a little with the fear of God than great treasures and troubles therewith. And they say, oh, you know, I'll take it to somebody. You know, he will pray for this prophet. He's a prophet of God. You know, I will not take it to somewhere that is not church now. And you say, no, I will go with you. And that will be the beginning of demonic attack. So stay far away from them. Be content with such things that you have, I say unto you. And in that verse 19, it says, such is the fate of all who are greedy for money. It robs them from life. You see, when somebody is greedy, they will do whatever it takes to get money quick. Microwave money. They're not willing to work. They want to steal from those who have labored. They want to go into armed robbery. And, you know, when Satan knows that you're carrying a gun, he will give you the ability to use it. Okay? And, you know, when I watch on TV, especially in America, where there's so much gun crime, you see children, young people, They just go on. You get them, maybe they get upset and then they just start shooting. They just kill somebody, destroy lives. And recently, a young man was sentenced to 60 years in jail for killing. He killed some, you know, he just went crazy. And even when he was in court, he was still, you know, laughing. He found it funny. 60 years, you know. So, and evil communication corrupts good morals. So, you know, if you hang around with those kind of people, people in back home, they say, if you walk with a dog, you eat shit, you eat poo. So you have to be very careful who your friends are. Like beget like. So stick with people who believe what you believe and who love God like you do. Praise God. Check your friends is the title of the daily devotional. And the memory verse is taken from Proverbs chapter 13, verses 20. And it says that he that walketh with wise men shall be wise, but a companion of fools shall be destroyed. So when you walk with somebody who is wise, you yourself will become wise. But a companion of fools, a fool is one that says there is no God. A companion of fools will be destroyed. Set. This is what the word of God is saying. Now, the only wise God, God is the only wise God, immortal, invincible. He's the only wise God. So if you walk with God, when we walk with God, we become more like him. Immortal, only wise God, to whom be power and dominion forever and ever. And Christ is the wisdom of God. The word of God is the wisdom of God. So the more we fellowship with the word of God, the wiser we become. Amen. So let's walk with God and walk with the children of God, those that love God. You know, and even sometimes in church, there's some friends that you cannot have. They will pull you down spiritually. You just be in church and you'll be carnal. So be very, very careful. Check your friends. You should do a thorough check on your friends to see if they are headed for heaven, Pastor says. There are some people who should clearly be avoided, while others may look good on the outside, but deep inside are not who they pretend to be. You need to stay away from such friends. Stay away from them. Courage is the ability to cut off anybody who should not be in your life quickly. I remember some years back where I used to work, there was somebody who was a lady who was my friend, you know. She were from the same part of town, so we, you know, gisted, you know, just talked at work, talked about so many things, and we're quite, you know, good friends, you know. And then one day the Spirit of God said to me, be careful with her, just on a regular day. And so I just prayed and said, Lord, anything that is hidden, let it be revealed. And she began to manifest some kind of attitudes that were not from God. And one day we were just talking. I think we were talking about some pastor. And she said something about pastors. And what she said, whatever she said, caused an eruption in my spirit. I felt the Holy Spirit being grieved, of which I literally felt in my physical body that the Spirit, what she said, grieved the Holy Spirit. And I knew that was it. And from then, hello, hello. I'm sure she herself was wondering, is everything okay? I said, everything is fine, you know. But that was the end of the relationship. Praise God. So we've got to be very careful. Now, Pastor says there are some character flaws you should look out for and ensure you do not keep people who have such as friends. For example, if your friend's temper runs hot, stay away from him or her so that you don't learn his or her ways and then snare your soul. Proverbs 22, verses 24 to 25. It says, so Pastor is saying that if you want to know the kind of friends you should have, if you have a friend that has a hot temper, that is a sign to you that this person must not be your friend. Why? Because the Bible says in Proverbs 22, verses 24 to 25, it says, make no friendship with an angry man, and with a furious man thou shalt not go, lest thou learn his ways and get a snare to thy soul. So he's saying that the spirit of anger is contagious. So if you have a friend that gets angry easily, that is so angry, he gets so upset, he's, you know, little thing, he gets crazy, that is a sign that this person cannot be your friend. Amen. Because the Bible, and this is why it's good to study the word of God, because some, you know, God will just send his word to you, at, you know, that make no friendship with an angry man and with a furious man, so that you don't learn his ways, because that spirit is contagious. Now, I didn't even, you know, you didn't even know that except the word of God tells you. But God is saying that to you, that, you know, if you have a friend and that person has a hot temper, wave the person goodbye. That person cannot be your friend, so that you do not partake of that spirit. Pastor then gives a testimony. He says, many years ago, I was working as a teacher and befriended a colleague who was from the same part of the country as I. I, however, didn't know much about him. One day on our way to Ibadan for a teacher's program, we got off the lorry in Ilefe, where we would board another to Ibadan. The friend of mine then said he wanted to say hello to a chief nearby and asked me to come along. I did, and after all, we were friends. We got there, he knocked on the door and was asked a strange question from inside. Is it a fish or a crab? My friend answered, one fish and one crab. We were let in, but as we left, I began to wonder what this strange statement meant. When we arrived in Ibadan, he said he wanted to visit another fellow. I followed him. He knocked at the door and was asked, who is that, a goat or a sheep? And my friend answered, one goat and one sheep. By now, I was seriously troubled. I got home and asked the elders what this statement meant. They said knowingly, ah, where did you hear that? So Pastor is saying that, you know, he's giving us a, you know, an example of sometimes your close friend, because you tend to spend more times in the day, more hours in the day with your colleagues than with your family. Yeah, so he had a friend that, you know, he was working with, and they were quite friends, you know, and they were going for a seminar together. And his friend said to him, I want to just see somebody. Do you want to come along? He said, oh, sure. And when they got to that place, when they knocked the door, somebody said, is it a fish or a crab from inside? And his friend answered, one fish, one crab. What does that mean? What meaning is this? And then they went on, and when they got somewhere, he said, oh, I want to see somebody quickly. You follow me. And he followed him again. And when they were at the door, the person from inside answered, is it a goat or a sheep? And his friend answered, one goat and one sheep. That's very, very weird, isn't it? So, and he didn't know what it meant. But when he got home and he asked the elders what it meant, they were like, what? Where did you hear that? You see, those are lingo that are very funny. You know, and so he knew that something was wrong. He said, that was the end of my friendship with that fellow. Up to today, I don't understand what those statements really meant, but I didn't have to be told that they were occultic and dangerous. And Pastor is saying, check your friends, be watchful and careful. So when the devil wants to, you've got to be very careful. You've got to, as a born-again Christian, you've got to be very selective, because Satan has come to steal and to kill and to destroy. You must not be naive. The Bible says that the human heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. So let your friends be those who are like you. Show me, so people in the world say, show me your friend and I'll tell you who you are. Okay. So and then another proverbs from that the elder says that he that walketh with a dog will eat poo. Because you have a tendency to be like who you relate with. And that's why the more we walk with God, the wiser we become. I'm far better than I was before I became born again. You know, Christ is my wisdom. And the Bible says that he that had no wisdom, let him ask from God, who gives liberally to all men. So God gives us wisdom. Christ is our wisdom. And so you see, even with this, I'm sure this is God intervened, because with this kind of occultic answers, they probably had intentions of doing something. I remember Dr. D.K. Olukoya, he gave a testimony about one guy. His friend said to him, I want to take you to this prophet. This prophet is very, very, you know, good. So when they went to the prophet and the prophet began to pray, he prayed, and when he prayed, he never mentioned the name of Jesus Christ once. So he said to the prophet, he said, you're a prophet. He said, yes. So while you were praying, you never mentioned the name of Jesus. And the prophet said, ah, don't mention that name here. So he said, why? He said, I said, don't mention that name here. And, you know, as he said, you know, he didn't want to go. And the prophet said, it's too late. It's too late. What you have seen here, you know, and that caused a lot of problems for him until he was delivered from the hands of the wicked. Be very, very careful. Be very careful who you let into your home. Be very careful with your friend. Even in church, there you have to be very selective. You see, the heavenly race, you've got to be very, very careful, okay, who you choose to be close to you. Because there are some carnal Christians in church, okay? Praise God. Now, Pastor then says that, check your friends, be watchful and careful, and listen to the Holy Spirit, I add. The Bible says evil communication corrupts good morals. 1 Corinthians 15:33, the Romans used to say that as bad apples spoil good ones, so do bad friends spoil good boys. Before today is out, do a thorough check on all your friends. If there are some that are not living a holy life, preach the word of God to them. And if they refuse to change, please separate yourself from such persons immediately. You see, and in fact, this is what courage is. When you find that this friend is not going the same way you are going, be very courageous to sever the relationship immediately. severed the relationship immediately. Amnon died. Amnon, the son of David, he died because his friend Jonadab gave him bad counsel. Praise the Lord. But if he said, oh, to his friend Jonadab that, oh, I love my sister Tamar. You know, I love Absalom, my sister's, Tamar, my Absalom sister. I love her. Jonadab would have said, are you okay? Have you been drinking? What's wrong with you? She's your sister. How can you have, say you love her, you know, and you know, say, no. Don't be as one of the fools in Israel, you know. But he instead, he was the one that plotted the rape. And then when Amnon died 2 years later, he was the one that still brought the news of Amnon's death. You know, so be very, very careful. Because when the enemy wants to attack, he usually come through somebody who is close. May God help us and give us wisdom in Jesus' name. And the thing is that, let me just add this. You see, I'm talking at the low level for children who are in school, for adults, but also even in the Christian circles. You've got to be very careful. It's not every pastor friend that, you know, you have to be close to. Some are carnal. Praise God. May the Lord give us wisdom. Now, a key point is your friends are an indication of the influences that determine who you will become. Make and retain only godly friends. Make and retain only godly friends. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you because you sent your word. It healed them, healed us, and delivers us from destruction. Indeed, your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light onto our path, and we give you thanks. Father Lord, we pray, Almighty God, that the wisdom of God will walk in us, Almighty God, to make the right choice, to choose the right friends in the name of Jesus Christ. Father Lord, we ask, Almighty God, that you help us, Almighty God, that we be as wise as serpents and subtle as doves in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father Lord, you that searched the heart, you know it, what is the mind of the spirit, and we pray that you help us to choose good friends, goodly and godly friends in the mighty name of Jesus, who will be a blessing to us in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Heavenly Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Thank you so much for listening to me. My name again is Sister Temi Tayo, and while you're on my channel, please do subscribe, and God bless you. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. God bless you.